Well, most of us only get a few weeks off a year for rest and relaxation, but for our reporter, David Robinson, that holiday just keeps on going. We're not really sure if he's actually working or what. Where are you, Robbo?
Well, Sarah, I've got to say, since I became a Studio 10 reporter, you've done some pretty interesting things to me. I mean, you put me in a Mentos suit and dunked me in a vat of Coke. Mm-hmm. You've made me swim with great white sharks. You even made me go to the Denny Ute muster. So I thought it was time for a bit of triple R. Oh, wait a minute. It's my 9 o'clock medicine call. Thank you, Chloe. Now, obviously, triple R is Robbo, rest and relaxation. And you're probably seeing some palm trees in the background, some beautiful sand, some beautiful water. And you might be thinking it's Fiji or the Maldives. Now, to me, those are rubbish tips in the ocean. I'm somewhere a little closer to home. I'm at Moreton Bay, on Moreton Island, at the beautiful Tangalooma Island Resort, just 75 minutes off the coast of Brisbane. Now, Tangalooma, here you can do anything you want. It's what you make it. Absolutely. Clap for Tangalooma. Here we go. Hold on.
It's
yeah, there we go. Sorry, I thought I was working for a bit there. So here you can do anything you want, and it is the world's third largest sand island. And the only way to get around that is obviously one of those little ships from Star Wars. We don't have that. We have the next best thing. And you will never feel more masculine than having four wheels between your legs. It's quad biking. It was amazing. Take a look.
Now on the day I was born, the nurses all gathered round. She could tell right away that I was bad to the bone, bad to the bone, bad to the bone, bad.
Now, there's nothing like riding a big piece of machinery in the morning. I love it, and I know you do too, Vince. Welcome to the show. Now, tell me, you're in charge of the quad bikes here in Tangalooma. Who can do it?
Anyone under the age of 10 can ride on the back with mum and dad. Anyone above that can ride by themselves.
That's awesome. Now, it is the world's third largest sand island, so there's a lot of sand to cover, isn't there?
Yes, there is.
The best way to do it here, isn't it?
Fantastic. I love it up here. It's brilliant. The tracks are awesome. Everyone will love this place.
It's like your own little deserted island just to explore by quad.
I would totally agree with that one, yeah.
Oh, it really is so much fun. And you're cruising around the ocean in some of the most amazing scenery you will ever see. You're coming up the coastline, you're seeing the beautiful shipwrecks in the background. It is one of the most amazing things I've ever done. Now, coming up from this island paradise, we're going to have a go at sand tobogganing. You don't know what that is, you want to stick around for that. And also later in the show, we get up close and personal with one of the most beautiful creatures in the ocean. You won't want to miss it. It's all coming up, but I've got to take a break because this has been very tiring for me. I'll see you soon. All
the best. Rub it in. He's funny. That's why he gets away with it. We love our Robbo.
And also, I don't know if anyone at home, if you heard Sarah before, but anyone who was concerned with Robbo holding the drink, that was a virgin. And also, the drink was non-alcoholic.
Are you sure?
Have a lot of hot topics to get into, but first, look, most careers are full of high stress and long hours. That is, unless you are our reporter, David Robinson. He's finding a way just to put himself on the best jobs ever. He's always out of the office. This time he's doing a story on a tropical island.
Funny how all of those stories seem to involve luxury resorts.
Yeah. How are those stress levels, Robbo?
Oh, they are so high right now, Sarah. hold on a minute. My legs are very sore. Let me just relax here for... Oh, that's a bit better. Oh, that's so much better now. Okay, so we are at Tangalooma Island Resort, which is just a hop, skip and a jump away from Brisbane in this beautiful Moreton Bay. And there is so much to offer. We had to do a lot of research yesterday. We did a little bit of snorkeling around the beautiful wrecks here on Tangalooma. We saw fish, we saw turtles. It was a beautiful time. We also tried our hand what's called stand-up paddleboarding, but it was more like fall-off paddleboarding for me. I tried my best. But there are so many beautiful activities here, and Tangalooma is what you make it. Sorry, I'm feeling very part. Sorry, I'm very, very thirsty. Here we go, Chloe. Thank you so much. Tangalooma looks after you. They are always around. Oh, they're always around for you. Now, guys, have you heard of sand tobogganing? It is one of the weirdest and craziest things I've ever done. Now, this is the world's third largest sand island, as I mentioned before, and we go for a bit of a desert safari inside the island and come to these massive dunes. Now, they're 30 metres high. That might not sound that high, but when you walk up them and you look down, it is huge. You get given these very scientifically and technologically advanced boards, and you go head first down the sand at speeds of up to 60 kilometres an hour. You've got to see it to believe it. Take a look. All right, Paul, it's almost time for sand tobogganing. I'm looking at this massive hill here. How big is it?
This hill's about 30 metres or 100 feet in the old money.
OK. Yeah. And how fast do you come down?
Ooh, depending on your skill levels, 40, 50, 60 kilometres an hour.
If your skill level is low, like I think mine is, how fast will I go then?
When you go over the handlebars, probably about 30 kilometres an hour over the handlebars.
All right, let's hope I don't do that. All right, so how long will it take us to get up there? It
takes you around about 10 minutes to walk up.
All right, it's probably going to take me about 20, so we should get started.
OK, let's go.
Let's go. My God, Paul was not kidding. That was absolutely amazing. You come hurtling down the thing and you don't think you're going to stop. And I've got my good friend Jen here. Jen, how did you go?
I did it. I was surprised myself. It was a bit nerve-wracking. Just the walk up there was nerve-wracking.
I know, that scared me and took it out of me. It took about 30 minutes. And when you came hurtling down, what were you thinking? Was your life going before your eyes?
No, I just wanted to get down.
So it just proves that anyone can do it, can't they, Jen?
Oh, yeah, yeah. If I can do it, my age, yep.
And you had fun?
I did, yep. I could do it again.
You want to do it again?
Yep.
All right, Jen can do it. I'm going to do it too. Let's go, Jen. I said speed, give me what I need. It was the most amazing thing that I've ever done, but I've got to tell you, it was so scary. You're looking down, as I said before, and you just think, nah, this is not going to work. You start sliding and you are flying like an eagle. But I will tell you this, you will find sand in places on your body that you never knew existed. It's all fun, but I've had about 5 showers and I'm still finding the little granules of beauty. Now, you too can enjoy everything that we've enjoyed here today. The very good people at Tangalooma have got an amazing prize, and I'm going to tell you a little bit more about later. But to enter, you can head to tangalooma.com and this could be yours. Also, coming up a little later in the show, I'm going to get up close and personal with dolphins. I'm going to feed wild dolphins just in the water here. It was the most beautiful experience I could ever tell you about, and that's all coming up a little later. Sarah?
Fantastic. Wow. Thank you, Robert. How exciting.
That's amazing. I never even knew sand tobogganing existed, and now I feel like my life can't be complete until I've done it.
I know, and stay watching because we will tell you how you can win a trip to Tangalooma later on in the show. Now, some people have all the luck, especially our reporter David Robinson, who is at Tangalooma Island Resort off the coast of Brisbane. Good morning, Robbo. You're on a kayak now. And I hear you had a pretty special encounter last night.
Wait, how do you know about that encounter? Oh, you mean the dolphin. Right, yes, of course. Sorry, the dolphin, yes, yes. It was one of the most amazing experiences I've ever had. Now, it was started a long time ago by the owners here of Tangalooma Island Resort. It's a family-owned business. And Betty Osborne would come out and feed the dolphin. Hold on a minute. Watercrafts are not my friend. She would come out and she would feed the dolphins. And that has grown into one of the most amazing traditions ever. Now, they're wild dolphins, they're not in captivity, and they come right up to you and you feed them by hand. Aww. I spent a bit of time with Echo the other night, and it was amazing. Take a look. Some people have dinner with their boyfriends, some have dinner with their girlfriends, some have dinner with families. Tonight, I'm having dinner with a dolphin and Sue. Sue, welcome to Studio 10. Who have we got here?
Tonight we're feeding Echo, and he's a 22-year-old male dolphin.
Beautiful. Now, this is one of only a few places in the world that you can feed wild dolphins, isn't that right?
Yeah, absolutely. And we are actually recognised as having one of the world's best dolphin feeding programs, and that's because we do have very strict rules and regulations, and plus we don't have any real negative impacts on the dolphins. They're not dependent on us for their daily intake, and we only feed them a very small amount of their daily intake. So we do see them hunting before, during and after the feed.
So they come in here every night. You get dolphins in every night?
Yes, we do.
That's amazing. And so people who come to Tangalooma, they have the chance to actually feed these wild dolphins?
Yeah, absolutely.
Have you guys ever fed a dolphin before?
No, first time.
And how was it?
It was great. They like the fish very much, so they're like stealing it from each other.
Yeah. All right, it's time to give Echo here a little bit more herring. Who's ready for it? Yes.
Well, the crowd has spoken, Echo. It's time for dessert, my friend. Here we go. Yes. Beautiful. All right, so it's time that I find out if he'll come on a second date with me. Echo, will you come on a second date with me? Yes, he will. This has been an amazing experience. A pretty cool job for you, isn't it, Sue?
Yeah, absolutely. We all love our job here.
Yeah, absolutely. All right, Echo, well, it's time to buy me a drink, buddy.
It really was an amazing experience with Echo there. And as I said, it's a family-owned business and they also provide rescues here. They're really at the coalface of marine life here in Moreton Bay. So if they see something, they're able to help the dolphin or the turtle or whatever they see there with whatever they want. Now, I've got to tell you, even out here, I am working up a little bit of a thirst. Where's my Chloe? Chloe, good girl. Thank you. They really take care of you out here in Tangalooma. Chloe, thank you. Now, I have been talking all morning about a very special competition that Tangalooma has to offer. Now, they're offering a family of four, a beautiful island getaway. You can experience everything that I have, plus so much more. And I did say that it was a family-owned company, and the Osbournes, they won't hear of you paying for anything. They're going to take care of flights, accommodation, and a few tours and activities on this beautiful island getaway. All you need to do is head to tangalooma.com, and you could be right here. Sarah, I've got to get back to Sarah somehow, so I'll see you soon.
Fantastic.
I am so there.
What about Robbo's guns? Look how strong you are, Robbo.
I am working it today.
I just hope there's a pot of dolphins available to rescue him when he comes off the kayak.
It does look divine, though, doesn't it?
It's beautiful.
Oh, it's a sensational part of the world. Moreton Island is divine.
Yeah.
So there you go.